I told my team the toughest one for us to win was probably going to be the first one. The next game, the team will play Kansas or Northeastern, are not better than New Mexico State. They're as good. That's just a great compliment to New Mexico State. But our kids worked hard to build that lead, and obviously we did not do a great job of taking care of the ball, but give New Mexico State credit for pushing us to the limit.
Let's direct questions now, if we could, to Auburn student-athletes Jared Harper and Javon McCormick, and when we've exhausted those questions, we'll turn it over to questions for Coach Pearl. Question for Auburn student-athletes.
Question for Jared Harper. Jared, every time they made a run there in the second half, seemed like you came up with a big shot. Same in the SEC championship. Talk about the play in the second half and the timely shooting from the three-point line from you.
I feel like I started to shoot the ball well. I was able to get downhill and get a layup early in the second half. That really helped my confidence. And now I think I hit my first three to start the second half. So just being able to make plays, my teammates trusted me. So.
More questions for Auburn student-athletes.
Jerry, what's the atmosphere like at the end of the game in the final minute of an intense NCAA first-round matchup?
Well, like Coach said before, we knew our first game was going to be our hardest game. We kind of made some plays down the stretch that didn't help us. We made a lot of mistakes. Me personally, I made a couple mistakes, a couple turnovers, a bad foul situation at the end and getting myself out of the game. So. I'm just glad I have my teammates bail me out.
Javon, you're flashing the choke gesture in those last free throws. Were you hoping to get the free throw shooter's attention there?
Yeah, I know. I see it in his face. He was pretty scared. We knew coming in there was a bad free throw shooting team, so that played a key.
Javon, could you kind of describe the Auburn swagger for me?
I feel like I really can't tell you. We all got a chip on our shoulder, so we just come out with that swag, and yeah.
All right, we'll dismiss the student athletes and then direct questions to Coach Pearl. Thank you, guys.
You guys are spectacular.
Thank you, guys. Thanks.
Can I follow up on that chip, that swagger?
Sure.
I'm glad you think we have a swagger. But I think the hesitation in answering the question is because I'm not so sure our kids do in this sense. He came back with it. He says we kind of got a chip on our shoulder. Javon was not a heavily recruited player. Most of our guys were 3 and 4 3-stars. So we've developed a confidence and a trust in one another and our depth as the season's progressed, but I don't know that we really have a swagger yet.
Bruce, how agonizing for you was that last few minutes of that game? I mean, have you ever been involved in anything quite that preposterous?
Dana, the only time I can remember almost losing it like that was when we did lose it, Jared's freshman year against Missouri, first round of the SEC tournament. And it was kind of unfolding the same way. No matter how many times you practice your spacing and what you want to do in those situations, until you get that moment, you just don't know how you're going to react. We obviously panicked and made our share of mistakes, which could have cost us the game. But at the same time, we had made enough really good plays throughout the game against a really good team. And that's a really good 5-12 win for Auburn, because that New Mexico State team is formidable. I don't want to do it again, though.
Coach, on that final sequence, you know they were going to look for a lob towards the basket. I thought your defense did a great job of forcing it in the middle, forcing the kick out, and a wild three. Was that the plan, you know, tuck into the middle and force a long jumper?
Again, Chris did a great job with that call. You know, thinking 1-7, we got to protect the rim. They've got some good lob things in there. So I put my center, one of my centers on the ball. I actually played two centers, one to protect the rim. But we did not switch out on the ball side shooter. And so that was a mistake, and they got a clean look, and they could, you know, obviously could have knocked it down, but we got a contest, and we're fortunate.
Bruce, do you take anything from this game and apply it to the next round?
Could you repeat that? I apologize.
Do you take anything from this game and apply it to the next round?
Guys, this was our fifth game in 8 days. Stop and think about that. This was our fifth game in 8 days. It looked like it. Bryce was tired. Jared was exhausted at the end of that game. And so I think what I'm going to take away is that we're going to be fresher. Horace, he's the energy bunny out there. He didn't have a ton of energy. This is his fifth game in 8 days. We played Sunday. We traveled all the way across the country. And we had to play hard because of the way New Mexico State plays. Our kids were popped at the end.